Hello and welcome. You're watching NDTV, the big story right now. Over 40,000 cases have been reported in Maharashtra in the last 24 hours, which is the highest number of daily cases till date. Even Mumbai has reported the highest ever number of daily COVID cases so far at 6,923 new COVID cases and 8 deaths reported in the last 24 hours. The cases in Maharashtra have been spiraling upwards in the last few days, due to which the Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray has asked officials to prepare for another lockdown. As he says, COVID protocol is not being strictly adhered to. A meeting that was held today that was attended by the Chief Minister, the Health Minister, Chief Secretary and other senior officials, and a warning was given that the death toll may increase. And the Chief Minister also expressed concerns that there may be a shortage of medical facilities due to the growing number of infections.
There definitely has been acceptance. In fact, the mall has been closed, people have left, restaurants are shut, and most people have gone home. That's what it is at this point. And the Chief Minister is already talking about lockdown like restrictions, and that's because the cases are still continuing to rise, with a record rise even today, over 6,000 cases in Mumbai. So obviously this is something that is going to be a worry for the administration in Maharashtra. The situation is not great here, and that's something that the administration is keeping a close eye on. In fact, they are, in the meeting that was held between the health minister, the chief minister and other top authorities of the state, what seems to have been decided is that the administration has been told to prepare for lockdown-like restrictions. What does that mean? Sources are telling us that transport is one thing that they're not going to touch. They're going to keep transport functioning. But shops, offices is something that they're going to ask people to keep shut for a while, perhaps, if at all those restrictions come into force. Now, this is something that perhaps will be decided after the 2nd of April. The government will meet, and that is something that will be clear then. But obviously, the situation is grim. It's worrying, the number of cases that have been going up. And while health experts have blamed it on a double mutant, COVID strain, the fact really is that whatever the strain may be, the numbers are definitely something that are really worrying. And what the administration fears is that it could put an added burden on the healthcare system, which has recovered from the first, wave. And that's why they're preparing so that that situation doesn't arise.
All right. So Saurabh Gupta reporting there from Maharashtra, where night curfews have kicked in. Meanwhile, let's take a look at the situation in the national capital. Delhi has reported over 1,800 coronavirus cases in a day, the highest in around 3.5 months. While the positivity rate has risen to 2.35%, the health department says 9 more people have died due to the disease, taking the count to 11,006. And there's more drama in Maharashtra politics after reports of a secret meeting between Amit Shah and Sharad Pawar. While Amit Shah's cryptic comments fueled speculation, the NCP has denied the meeting took place in a bid to quell rumours.
Amit sir, aap kal Ahmedabad mein the. Kuch aisi reports aa rahi hain ki Sharad Pawar ji aur Praful Patel ji dono Ahmedabad mein the. Chaliye, sab cheeze sarvajanik
nahi hoti hai.
Amit Shah's cryptic remark when asked about a secret meeting with Sharad Pawar in Ahmedabad, neither denying or confirming the meeting, but setting off massive speculation in political circles. The NCP chief is the architect of the Maharashtra Vikas Ahadi in Maharashtra, and there have been reports of friction between the Shiv Sena and the NCP over the last few days. Both allies have denied reports of friction, calling it a BJP ploy to destabilize the government. The NCP has denied that a meeting took place.
Gujarat ke ek akhbar Bhaskar mein jis tarah se khabar chhapi gayi ke Pawar sahab Parpul Patel Amit Shah se mile, hame lagta hai 2 din se Twitter pe afwahein phailai ja rahi thi. Ye matra afwah hai, is tarah ki koi bhi mulaqat nahi hui.
Well, I am only talking today of the Mahavikas Agadi government, which has been formed with the initiative of Shri Sharad Pawar. We are all aware that it was impossible to form a government. It was only and only due to Shri Sharad Pawar ji that such a government could be formed there. As far as the government is concerned, the MVA government is absolutely stable under the leadership of Shri Uddhav Thackeray.
The Shiv Sena this morning in its mouthpiece seems to be hardening its stand against Anil Deshmukh, while criticizing the government for not doing enough to defend against these attacks. In a column in the Samna, party MP and spokesperson Sanjay Raut wrote, Deshmukh got the Home Minister's post by accident after Jayant Patil and Dilip Valsipatil had refused it, and it is only then that Sharad Pawar handed over this post to Deshmukh. The piece also said, no individual can function as the Maharashtra Home Minister remaining close to dubious characters if a junior officer like Sachin Vaze was running a money collection racket from the Mumbai Police Commissioner's office. Why was the Home Minister not aware of it?
अनिल देशमुख जी 5 बार विधायक चुने गए, 18 साल वो राज्य मंत्री और मंत्री पद पे रहे और पवार साहब ने सोच समझ के उन्हें जिम्मेदारी दी, वो एक्सीडेंटल गृह मंत्री नहीं है।
Meanwhile, Anil Deshmukh says there will be a probe by a retired judge into the allegations against him made by former police commissioner Parambir Singh.
माननीय मुख्यमंत्री महोदय ने और राज्य शासन ने इस आरोपों की जांच रिटायर्ड हाईकोर्ट जज के द्वारा करने का निर्णय लिया है।
The allies within the Maharashtra Vikas Aghadi are set to meet again in the coming week to ensure better coordination as they rule out a threat to the government. With Saurav Gupta in Mumbai, Sarah Jacob, NDTV.
And the political battle has intensified in Assam, with the focus on the second and third phase of the polls, which are to be held on the 1st and 6th of April. The Assam NRC is emerging as a key issue, with the BJP promising a corrected NRC in its manifesto, hinting at the possibility of reopening the Assam NRC altogether. But the central government had recently rejected the state government's request for completing the pending NRC work, citing inordinate delays. So is the promise of a corrected NRC a mere poll rhetoric? Ratnadeep Chaudhary reports.
The BJP gearing up for the phase 2 of Assam polls. Among the 10 resolutions of the party, a corrected NRC for Assam.
NRC hum satta mein aayenge kyunki aapko malum hai Supreme Court ki nigah mein, Supreme Court ka strict supervision mein NRC state coordinator ne banaya tha, hai na?
But this letter dated 23rd March from the office of the Registrar General of India to the state government raises some eyebrows. In its letter, the Registrar General turned down the request for more funds to complete pending work for the Citizens Register and suggests the state government disband the surplus staff, hand over workload to the government staff and shift the NRC office to government building. As a result, the process has been stuck in a limbo since September 2019. Opposition and human rights activists accusing the government of doublespeak and playing electoral politics on the future of several lakh people.
Since 19 till now in 21, for the last 2 years, for all those citizens who are stranded, facing a bleak future, facing an uncertain future, what has the BJP done? Nothing but engage in rhetoric, and they gave this hope of a new NRC, and now that has myth has been busted by this letter of the Registrar General of India.
BJP in its manifesto says that they want a correct NRC. The Registrar General of India implies that the NRC that has been published on 31st of August 2019 is a correct NRC. So the bottom line is that BJP is politicizing the entire NRC.
While central authorities on one side wants pending works on the Assam NRC to be completed in a mission mode, the BJP wants to dump it and come up with a corrected one, making many wonder what exactly does the BJP hope to do with the NRC in Assam. With Manish Kumar in Guwahati, Ratnadeep Chaudhary for NDTV.
And the Union Home Minister Amit Shah's claim that the BJP will win 26 of the 30 seats for which polling was held in the first phase of the West Bengal Assembly elections a day ago earned a major eye roll from the Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, who says the people's verdict will be evident after votes are counted.
Kicking off the countdown to the big fight in the battle for Bengal, Mamata Banerjee back in Nandigram for the first time since 11th March, first stop Riapara, where she turned a cultural program into a fiery political one. And then at Birulia, the very same village where she had been injured on that day, landing her on a wheelchair to fight the biggest challenge so far in her political career.
Ami banglar me ami banglar mukhyamantri ekono thakbo agami din apnader ashirbade shubhechha dui ami jekhan theke icche darate pari কিন্তু সব ছেড়ে দিয়ে কেন আমি নন্দীগ্রাম মাটিতে এলাম আপনার মাটিটাকে প্রণাম করার জন্য সালাম করার জন্য এটা মাথায় রাখবেন
In Delhi, a day after Bengal polled in 30 seats, Amit Shah claimed 26 for the BJP, inviting Mamata Banerjee's mockery.
मैं मानता हूं कि बंगाल में हम 30 में से 26 सीट से ज्यादा भारतीय जनता पार्टी विजयी हो रही है
बीजेपी एक नेता आज के बोले 30টার মধ্যে 26 তো हमको मिलेगा 26 তো কেন 30 में 30 बोलो ना बोला 30 में 30 ही मिलेगा तब तो गोल्ला ज्यादा होगा ना रसगोल्ला खावे रस छाड़ा रसगोल्ला
Shubhendu Adhikari, her direct rival in Nandigram, hurled appeasement barbs at his former boss all day. Nandigram has nearly 30% minority.
Ekhe bhot deben, ekintu kolma ta thik pori. La ilaha illallah. Ei begom ke ekta bhoto deben na. Er pore golai konthi, dhuti ar mathay tik.
But Mamata Banerjee on a wheelchair is powerful optics and her links with the iconic land movement there in 2007 legendary. She is camping at Nandigram till polling day. Meanwhile, her former Rajya Sabha MP, now at the other end of the political spectrum, roadshowed through the districts.
But Nandigram, which catapulted Mamata Banerjee to the Chief Minister's chair in 2011, is an unpredictable battleground. With camera person Rizwan Khan in Nandigram and Monidipa Banerjee, Anurag Dwari for NDTV.
And the President has given his assent to the Government of National Capital Territory of Delhi Amendment Bill. The MHA is to notify the date on which this act will come into force. Less than 10 days after it was introduced in the Lok Sabha, the Government of National Capital Territory of India Amendment Bill 2021 got the approval of both houses of Parliament. Parliament passed the bill that gives more powers to the Delhi Lieutenant Governor on the 24th of March, a move that led to an outcry by the Kejriwal government and the bill. The act has now been given the assent of the President. And farmers camping at Delhi's borders burnt copies of the center's new farm laws that they have been protesting against during Holika Dahan. Pictures from the Singhu border show these protesting farmers how they celebrated Holi. They maintain that their agitation will continue till the farm laws are repealed. Mumbai policeman Sachin Vaze, arrested in connection with the Mukesh Ambani explosives scare case, was taken to the Bandra River by investigators on Sunday. Under his direction, divers recovered a hard disk and submerged number plates of a car. Two number plates of the same number have been found. The suspended officer, who was initially in charge of the explosives investigation, is also a suspect in the murder of Mansukh Hiran, the man who owned the SUV in which the explosives were found. The NIA, which is looking into the explosives case, is questioning Vaze, who will be in their custody till the 3rd of April.